Señor Secretario General de SOFOFA, Señor Andrés Robledo, Director General de la DIRECON, Señor Roberto Paiva, Director de ProChile, Señoras y señores representantes de empresas chilenas, quiero expresar mis sinceros agradecimientos a los responsables de SOFOFA y ProChile por esta oportunidad. Mi presentación será breve y se ocupará de las líneas generales de la política de inversión en Algeria. So I will be very brief, and I will give the major lines concerning the investment in Algeria. You know, there is two ways to sell products. If una empresa quiere vender un producto, hay dos maneras. The first way is go, for example, sell product, milk or fruta seca in Algeria. So it's the first way. The second way is to go to Algeria, invest in Algeria, and sell your products to other African countries. So I will start by giving a short overview about Algeria. Algeria, the hydrocarbons, it's gas and oil, it's 60%, 60% revenues. And over 95% of exportations. So it's 90% of our export earning and 60% of our budget revenue. Algeria is the seventh, is la siete position, largest gas, natural gas in the world. We are seventh. And the second, numero dos, largest gas exporters within the exporters countries. Another fact, Algeria implemented a rigorous macroeconomic stabilization program. Because before, as you know, we had a planned economy, una economia planificada. But starting in the 90s, we had another reforms. And the first thing to do, we had almost 30 billions of debt, national foreign debt. And we negotiated with Club de Paris about the debt in the 1990. And now our national debt of Algeria now, ahora, is 4.8 billions. So we pay all our debt, and we have less than $5 billion as a debt. Another fact, Algeria since 2000, this is annual 12,000, we had the plan of development plan in Algeria. The amount, the envelope of the money is $280 billion. Since 2000 until 2015 is $280 billion, and there was invested in Algeria. It's Algerian money, it's our fund. So, and the objective was to improve living condition of the people. And just between brackets, I saw a slide of, I think, the Secretary General of SOFOFA. And the population of Algeria no es 31 million, 38 millones. So it's just small correction. So the investment, the 280 billions, is to improve infrastructure also, and also to improve the business environment. So in order to help foreign companies to come in Algeria and this over there. I will give you some, just some points, the advantage of the position of Algeria. La position geográfica in the center of the North Africa, in centro del Maghreb and North Africa, and la proximidad geográfica también de Algeria para el mercado potencial in Europa, Africa, and Medio Oriente. So this is the first positive and natural element that Algeria has is the geographic position. The second thing is the size of the market. You know, you are companies who want to sell products. So the market is 38 million consumers. So 38 million, I think it's, we are 40 or 42 million. So, but officially we are 38 million. And also what we have is the size of the national, the industrial fabrics. We have steel, industry, petrochemical, and electronics. And the importance of the natural resources. We have oil and gas, and we have also a lot of resources not fully exploited. So we have resources that we are exploring and exploiting now, and we have resources we didn't explore yet. And I know that Chile has a long way in mining and other things. Like, for example, we didn't explore for phosphate, iron, gold, diamond. We have these resources, but we didn't start working on it. And also we have a positive way, it's the human resources. It's the same thing as in North Africa. We have the population is young and qualified. The second element that I want to talk about is Algeria. Algeria has, in the business world, we have association agreement with Europe. So association agreement since 2005, and we are part of the great, I know that a lot of people don't know this fact, it's the great Arab free trade zone. There is Arab free trade zone, and Algeria is part of it. It's like European trade free zone or other free trade zones. And the other thing that is, we are negotiating our accession to the World Trade Organization, WTO. And you know, there is the multilateral negotiation and the bilateral negotiation. At this day, Algeria has 6 agreements for the WTO bilateral. So this 6 agreement was signed with Argentina, Uruguay, Brazil, Venezuela, Cuba, and Switzerland. So until now, we have 6 bilateral agreements within the framework of WTO with these 6 countries, and we are negotiating with 18 others, USA, EU, Japan, Canada, Mexico, Australia, Salvador, Ecuador, India, Chinese Taipei, Malaysia, Indonesia, and Russia. So this is to give you the overview about Algeria. I will not talk a lot about because I have a lot of details, and I have documents here. When we finish, you will find it outside. With Mosdia, we have 3 documents. Data information and about the investment, and in Spanish, so someone translated it in the embassy. You will find it outside. The principles of governing the investment. It's freedom to invest, no discrimination, investment protection, and intangibilities of the benefits. So this is the main principle governing the investment in Algeria. I will speak shortly 5 points. First of all, the institutional framework It's like who are the institution in charge of the investment. So it's very quick. We have the National Council investment. We have the Ministry of Industry and Mine, who is the political institution in charge of the investment. And we have the National Agency for Investment Development. So these three institutions, so you will not talk, if you want to go invest in Algeria, you will not talk to other than these three bodies, and let's say two, because the ministry is in charge of the politics of investment in Algeria. So all the benefits, all the administrative forms and others and the requirement is with two, only with two bodies. The investor has the rights protected, so they can enjoy fiscal and custom incentive. They can transfer their capital or income. They have the possibility to appeal to an international arbitration if there is a difference. So it's the same standard rules that you find anywhere else. So it's not because it's Algeria and it's in the African continent. So we have this idea in our head. They are way far from the civilization. It's not the case at all. So the eligibility system, there is a very simplified rules. They are general rules to be eligible to invest in Algeria. And there is a process for granting benefits if a company come to Algeria and want to invest. So it's since the first day you will know what are your benefits, what are the advantages that you can get by starting investing in Algeria. So I will not talk about the details about the how is the scheme. So for benefits, you have general scheme, you have two other layers. So there is three schemes, so three major schemes for investment, and each scheme has its own benefits. So it's technical and so on, and since I came here, and I don't want to make it too technical because I am not economic or expert, so I will not do that. For the benefits, you can be granted a lot of benefits based on the agreement scheme that you choose. For example, exemption from duty, taxes, exemption from transfer duty on real estate. For example, exemption from registration duty, exemption from the land tax if you want to buy land to construct infrastructure. So you can get exemption. Let me give you some examples, like concrete example for benefits for investors, for example, in agriculture. I know that Chile is a large agriculture producer. So there is, since 2009, there is a measure benefiting agriculture, the sector of agriculture. So they can have, for example, exemption for tax value added until, it means since 2009, until December 2018. So if you are a Chilean investor and you invested in agriculture, for example, for milk producing facility, or for example, for leasing silo, for cold storage equipment, and so on. If you invested in this kind of activities, you will be benefiting from this exemption since 2009 until 2018. For example, the tourism sector. If you are, I know that Chile is very nice touristic country. and you have very, very active operator in tourism. So if there is agency or a company who want to invest in tourism sector, they can have a period of 5 years of exemption. For example, for acquisition of equipment, furnishing, or if they want to renovate or upgrade existing facilities, so or construct tours, hotels, spa, and restaurant. So they will have a lot of benefits. For example, a reduction of tax added value from 17 to 7%, or they can get a benefit of period of 10 years without paying two or three taxes. I will not give you. I have a lot of examples, but just I choose these two: agriculture and tourism. Algerian policy in Africa. Within the continent, Algeria has a long-term strategy. We decided to erase the debt of 14 African countries. It's the amount of 1.2 billion US dollars. So we erased this the debt of 14 African countries, and we prospect converting other debt to existing debt to asset for this in this country. So Algeria want to expand its economic influence in half dozen countries in the Sahel, like Niger, Mali, Mauritania, but also in Burkina Faso, Cameroon, and Senegal. The other thing is Algeria is one of the five founding countries of NEPAD. NEPAD is a very important issue. It's the new partnership for African development. And it's the strategic framework of the African Union for socio-economic development of the continent. So it's very important strategic and economic and social instrument. In La Verdad, Algeria is not economically very present in Africa, so it's 0.15% of our exports go to Africa. So it's not the case. It's more political and security level, especially with the body within the African Union and the axis Algiers, Lagos, Pretoria in South Africa, which intend to establish itself in the continent. Algeria invested in Africa, within Africa. You will say why we are talking about Algeria investing in Africa, but you will see why. Invested for the construction of trans-Saharan routes. Before we was talking about infrastructure and for transportation of product and logistic and so on. This is part of the logistic. So the construction of the trans-Saharan route. And Algeria already invested $3 billion USD to construct its road from Algiers to passing by Niger and so on until Nigeria. And another thing in the old oil infrastructure, Algeria also is projecting to construct a pipeline from Nigeria, Niger to Algeria, and it will be near the European market. And I will give you information. Algeria, it's pro-Chile, there will be interested. Algeria is preparing a large economic and commercial gathering meeting. It's called Algeria Africa. So we are working on that, and a lot of operators from all the African countries will be present. In this race against time to Africa, Algeria appears increasingly as obvious gateway to the economic potential of Africa. We had the business delegation participating in the 47th edition of Algiers International Fair. It's a good initiative, and the Chilean companies has everything to gain to enroll in a dynamic partnership with the Algerian entrepreneur. We have what we call the triangular partnership. So Chile, a Chilean company who want to sell its products, instead of selling directly, it can sell, for example, to Algeria the product, and from there, stay there, invest a little bit, and sell its products, not only for Algeria, but for the other country that Algeria has already with them. We have infrastructure, we have agreement, we have facilities, and everything. So this is what we call the triangular partnership. So the Chilean companies and empresas have everything to gain to our role in a dynamic partnership with the Algerian entrepreneur. Chile could well become more competitive and create networks in Algeria and beyond in all Africa. As a reminder, with 5 to 6% growth in Africa, Africa, this country is true land of opportunity. It houses Africa, the African continent, it houses the greatest global potential of raw materials. So the African continent has the greatest, the global greatest potential of raw materials. Yeah. And 60%, the African continent has 60% of the unexploited arable land of the planet. So this is what Africa can give. And let me tell you something. If you want to sell products, you have to be there. Doesn't mean that you have to establish a company and so on, but you have to be present in the country where you want to buy your products. And thank you very much.